If extraterrestrial life exists somewhere in the universe, how will we find them? And if they're so unlike anything we've seen before, will we even be able to detect them? These were some of the questions that were circulating around the Astrobiology Science Conference last week in Bellevue, Washington. So here's a summary. Basically, we have not yet found aliens, but the good news is that scientists are coming up with new ideas every day on how to detect them. A common theme throughout the conference was that we could look at extreme environments on our own planet to see how life survives there, because similar conditions could exist elsewhere in the universe. For example, scientists are looking at an underwater volcano in Hawaii called the Lauihi Seamount, which is made up of these hydrothermal vents, which are openings on the seafloor that pump out heated water and minerals. And the Cassini spacecraft a while ago had found evidence that one of Saturn's moons, Enceladus, also had similar vents. So if life can exist in these weird environments on our own planet, why can't they on Saturn's moon? Last week, NASA announced a new mission. The new Dragonfly spacecraft will explore Titan, which is another one of Saturn's moons, for signs of life. Titan is very similar to an early Earth, and scientists also hope that it can teach us a bit about how life arose on our own planet, something that we're still not sure of. Scientists are also trying to come up with novel signatures that could indicate the presence of life elsewhere in the universe. For example, if life evolved like ours did on our planet, could we detect the technological signals that they're giving off? But these signals don't have to be technological. They could be gases, for example, emitted by tiny organisms. One group thinks that a very toxic gas on our planet called phosphine could actually signal the presence of life elsewhere in the universe. That is because phosphine only becomes toxic when it's mixed with oxygen. So if there's oxygen-free worlds out there, maybe they would happily produce phosphine and we could detect it. It's known that certain life, such as microbes, on our planet produces phosphine in oxygen-free environments, such as in the intestinal tracts of fish and human babies, but it's unknown why in the world they expend so much energy producing it. That was a brief glimpse of some of what I learned at last week's Astrobiology Science Conference. Check back for more stories.